Hi guys, in this video I will show you how to set up reference mixing in Bitwig Studio. Reference listening or reference mixing is a great way to achieve a professional sound and also compare your mixes with your favorite artists. Furthermore, you can also use reference listening or reference mixing to make sure that all the tracks of your next album has the same kind of mix quality. Before we begin today, I'd like to announce episode 28 in the Bitwig Studio Masterclass. Episode 28 deals with instrument layer sound design, voice stacking, macro modulators, remote controls and much more. Now, if you like my content here on YouTube and want a full plus 4-hour course in Bitwig Studio, you can sign up to my masterclass at store.morningdewmedia.com. Right, so let's look at how to set up reference mixing in Bitwig Studio. Okay, so here we have a Bitwig project from my album Time Lullaby. It's a track called Among Us. And when we're talking about AB reference listening or reference mixing, you often have an A mix and a B mix. The A mix will be your song project. In this case, it's my track here called Among Us. And the B mix will be your reference track. So first out here, we need to set up our A mix, our Bitwig project. And the first thing you want to do here is select all your tracks and press Command and G, Control G on Windows to put all those tracks into a single group. Now, if you press Tab to open the mixer and go to the right side here, you can see that it reads AB. And if you press the button, you open the AB reference mixing functionalities. And we will set the group A here to the A mix. You can also set it to B mix, but we will put our original song on the A mix part. And to make this work properly, if you have aux tracks, like in this case, I have two like effect tracks. We have the color copy delay and crystalline reverb. We also want those to output into the group here. We don't want them to output to the master, which is often the default output. So set it to group, group one master, and do the same thing for all your effect buses. That way, if we play back the track, all audio will go into the group mix here, the group bus. So if we play back the track now, and if I press mute, you can see that all the effects and the original tracks in the group here are muted. Now you might also have some effects on your master track, like compressors, maybe saturation, equalizers and such. Now we need to move those effects from the master track into our group track instead, because we want to treat that group track as our master track, because you don't want the B mix to be processed by all those compressors and limiters and stuff. So let's move over my master chain here to the group track and also this natives only chain. It's not activated, but I will move it here anyway. Now the spectrum analyzer and the Julien loudenspeeder that we have on the master track, we will leave those on the master bus because we can use those to measure both the A mix and the B mix output. So let's leave those two on the master bus. Okay, so the A mix is now properly set up and now we need to set up our B mix, the reference track. So let's go into Finder and find the reference track. Let's drag in the track Green Keys from my album Time Lullaby. And let's listen if we have some audio. Yes. Now we open up the mixer and set the AB mix output of our reference track to the B mix. Now look below the master track and we can see this slider for the A and B mix. If you have this all to the left, we will hear our original track, and if it's all to the right, we will only hear the B mix, which is this, the reference track. So that's my original track, the Bitwig project, and if we drag this to the right, we only hear the B mix. Now I also advise you to set up a remote control to control this AB mixing. And to do that, we press this MIDI control mapping and we press this area and move a knob on our MIDI controller. And now it's super simple to use the MIDI controller to control if we're going to hear the A mix or the B mix. Now, if you want to mix your original track to be more like the reference track, you just stack up all the kind of mastering plugins that you need on the group track here, rather than on the master bus, because we're considering this group track as our like master bus. While the master, the like physical master output here, is only used for spectrum analysis and for final loudness metering. Now a final thing here, if we're playing back the A mix and fade to the B mix, look at the master meter here. You might wonder why do we have like plus 2.7 dB and we go like into the red. That's because we have volume buildup when we have a little bit of the A mix and a little bit of the B mix playing at the same time. It will be volume buildup. You can also attach this to a button so you can just flip between the A mix and the B mix, but on this MIDI controller I only have knobs, so I'm using a knob here to like fade between the A mix and the B mix. But you probably want to attach this to a button so you just can flip it between the A and the B mix. Like instantly. Okay, so we can probably talk mixing in ages here, but this is basically how you set up a reference listening, AB reference mixing in Bitwig Studio. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to ask them in the comments section below. Now you can continue and watch my next episode. And again, don't miss out on my Bitwig Masterclass. See you in the next episode. Bye.